Hey everybody, it's time for a throwback draft. Today it's triple time spiral draft, which is a format that I liked a lot when I was young, and going back and playing it this week, it's even more fun than I remember. The cards are just more interesting for limited than they are nowadays. Everything is an activated ability, and the synergies are more subtle. For example, combining a spell with suspend with a spell that has storm, instead of combining an elf with something that's good when you have an elf in play. It's just, a thinking man's format. I like Time Spiral a lot. This format has a particular soft spot in my heart because it was a time in my career when I was becoming a serious player and playing a lot, but I still wasn't, reading strategy articles or following coverage or anything like that. So a lot of the strategies that I developed were just purely my own, and I just kind of like to do my own thing. My favorite thing to draft has always been the Black Madness deck. You just get lots of removal and some card advantage and madness synergies with creatures that let you discard cards and, play things discounted or whatever it might be. But I also like drafting green a lot, and going into this draft, I'm just going to be completely open to what we see. Okay, Arena, a land that lets me fight creatures. Probably pretty good in a green deck. Not sure if I want to first pick that. Magus the Jar, no good. Clockwork Hydra is fine. Empty the Warrens is fine. Temporal Isolation is a standout card. This is like a pacifism, maybe even better than pacifism, has flash. So I'm going to take Temporal Isolation unless I think about it a little more and decide that this Arena card is really good. I guess it's great if I have the biggest creature on the battlefield. It doesn't tap for mana, so I'd have to count it kind of as a spell in my evaluation, in my deck building. I'm just going to take the Temporal Isolation. I know this card is really good. But here's an example of why I like Time Spiral. Instead of the rares just being either useless or insane bombs, they're all just kind of different. They're offbeat. You have to think about them. So here, Magus the Scroll is a pretty good card. It's like Cursed Scroll, except a little more fragile because it's a 1/1 creature. And there is a lot in this format that punishes one toughness guys. But I like this card quite a lot. Otherwise, Lightning Axe is pretty good. Temporal Isolation or Tendrils of Corruption. So really, I'm going to narrow this down to a second copy of Temporal Isolation or the Magus of the Scroll. I guess it's exactly the same as the last pick. I have an on-color card that I know is really good, but I just have to think whether this rare is a bomb or not. And I think I'm going to make the same decision to just stick on-color, pick the Temporal Isolation. I don't know that red and white necessarily combine that well. I guess you can just build an aggressive weenie deck. You can even do tokens with like fortify. All your attacking creatures get +2/+0. But I'd rather stay on color for now. And perfect. Knight of the Holy Nimbus is a perfect example of a card that's going to be good in a heavy white deck. For those that don't know, it is a 2/2 flanking that is basically really annoying to kill. The opponent has to pay 2 mana anytime they would want to kill it. So that means you can attack freely into it if your opponent. You can attack freely with this card if your opponent taps out. You can block bigger guys or equal size guys and make them spend their turn. And if they have like an expensive removal spell, they're never going to be able to hit the knight with it. So that's definitely what I'm taking here. This is fun, actually. I haven't drafted white in a long time, but I have seen some pretty nasty white weenie decks, and it'll be fun if I can get one of those. So I'm guessing that among the viewers, there's pretty wide range in terms of experience level with Time Spiral Draft. Some of you probably have never seen the cards before, and some of you probably either were serious players back then or have been drafting a lot on Magic Online. But anyway, I'll try to keep my commentary basic for those of you that are just learning the format. Vati Ildal a pretty good card, but double off color. Not that interested. I'm almost definitely just going to take Temporal Isolation, stay mono white. It's pretty insane. This is like high in the running for the best common in the set, and just have three of the same common, three of the same great common on color in pack one is a really nice start. I mean, it'd be also fun if I had three Tendrils of Corruption and was drafting mono black, but this is probably a better, more efficient card and leaves my options open. I can play a second color if I need to. Okay, let's look at this Pegasus. 1/2 flying that makes spells deal less damage. Okay, that's medium. Zealot Ilvek is a little overpriced. If it attacks and is not blocked, it can deal 1 damage to a creature, so good against 1 toughness guys. And it is a white creature. Best card in this pack is probably Urborg Siphon Mage, which I like in that Black Madness deck, but it's not necessarily where I'm going here. I think I'm probably just going to take the Zealot Ilvek, stay on color. This Undying Rage could be really good if I had decided to go for the red-white super aggressive deck. +2/+2 and can't block, and whenever this goes to the graveyard, it turns to my hand. But when in doubt, stay on color. Nice shadow creature pickup here is cool. Spine Sliver. Well, good in a red-green sliver deck, but that is not what I'm drafting. Fortify. Good if I get some token stuff going on, but not the type of card that I generally love. Otherwise, I'm probably looking at going into red for a Flame Core Elemental, which is a good card, but not incredibly exciting. I guess I'll just go with the Fortify. Okay, Quilled Sliver can deal damage to attacking or blocking creatures. If I'm going to be mostly white, maybe dipping into a second color, I don't necessarily know that I'm going to get a lot of slivers, but this guy's fairly respectable just on his own, making combat difficult for my opponent. I could also take another Zealot Ilvek. I would probably err on the side of the sliver before that. Might Sliver is great, actually. This is a card that probably shouldn't be going so late. Assassinate's also strong, as is Penumbra Spider, so this is just a very good pack. Is it time to go for a second color? No, I'm just going to take Quilled Sliver. Figure if I do end up with a sliver deck, I'm going to miss having the Quilled Sliver anyway, so that's my logic. I'm not taking Might Sliver. Not necessarily correct logic, but that's what I'm going to decide. So Terramorphic Expanse would be great if I wound up playing three colors. Doesn't seem likely with what I have so far. Prismatic Lens is more for like a big mana ramp deck, like a five-color green or, you know, multicolor green deck. De-Avenant Healer, similar to the Quilled Sliver. I guess it's fine. I will just take that. So I guess this is a little, maybe I'm not doing a great job drafting. It's a few picks in a row where I've picked slightly worse white cards over going into a second color. Okay, now I have Harmonic Sliver if I wanted to go into green. Don't necessarily want to do that. Errant Doomsayers is not that exciting. It's really only good if I get a Rebel theme. And then there's this Arena that came back around, which, as I mentioned originally, is only going to be great in a green deck, but it can allow me to kind of snipe down little weenies. I don't know. I'm just going to take Errant Doomsayers. It is a Rebel, and I'll be snapping up any Rebel Searchers if I do see them. I think there's only one at common in this set, one at uncommon. All right, another Rebel, but one that's not that good. This card is fine. Kind of like a Sorcery Speed Griptide. Whatever, just stay mono white. Fortify. I guess if I am going to wind up playing these Fortifies, having a bunch of crappy creatures is exactly what I want. So, all right, now I will take Temporal Eddy. 5 mana for a 3/3 sliver is just not going to make the cut often enough. But if I do wind up white-blue, this is the type of spell that I'm going to want. Nice tempo spell to follow up my cheap white weenies. This card's pretty bad. Yeah, it's just way too bad. I'll take this. And this is like a way worse than Congregate. Ooh, that's a nice pickup. A playable white creature, pick 15. Yeah, this is just a life gain spell that I'm not going to be particularly interested in. Maybe for sideboard, but I doubt it. Okay, I have a burn spell. What does this do? Curse of the Cabal. Target player sacrifices half the permanents he or she controls rounded down. Seems not like what I want to be doing with this deck. Oh, there's my Rebel Searcher. Perfect. So I'm almost definitely going to take that, although this fledgling Maw Corps is a good card. I have a blue card, and this is exactly the card that I don't want to play against. But the on-color Rebel Searcher, I just can't pass it up. This card, Conflagrate, I'd like to mention. I remember as a kid, and also when I first came back to drafting this format, I would see this card and be like, wow, a Fireball, and pick it. But it really is a lot worse than Fireball and a lot worse than it looks. It is a playable card, but not very exciting. Or, I mean, not super exciting. Like, it's just a inefficient removal spell, basically. Yep. Okay, Felden's Cane shuffles my graveyard into my library. Not very good. Cloud Chaser Kestrel is pretty nice. Ooh, I didn't mean to pick that so quickly without looking at the rest of the pack, but that was the card that I was intending to pick also anyway. Okay, Gaze of Justice is an extremely hard card to use, but I have the exact deck for it, which is mono white weenie. I could also take Errant Ephemeron, extremely good blue creature. Sidewinder Sliver, not that exciting. I don't think I'm going to be going for any kind of dedicated Sliver deck. And then Strangling Soot is good, but double off color again. So the question really, I think, is if I want to take the Errant Ephemeron and maybe gamble on a chance of Gaze of Justice wheeling, or if I just want to take the Gaze of Justice. Well, I think I'll employ the same strategy that I've been going with the entire time, which is to stay on color when in doubt. So, sure. Now that I have a card like this, and I already have three removal spells, I really want to err on the side of all my cards being creatures. So, like, I find it unlikely that these fortifies are going to make my deck unless I get a bunch of token stuff. There's one card called Icacian Crier, maybe, that you can. It's a creature that lets you discard a card to put two 1/1 tokens into play. That could be good with fortifies. But in general, I'm going to try to keep it simple, just white creatures and a couple of well-placed removal spells. I still could go for a second color, naturally. Wow, this guy is kind of a bomb. Triple blue, though, not what I'm looking for. But doesn't look like there's anything great for me. That card is just expensive and bad. Crookclaw Transmuter is a card that would be more likely to make my deck than Teferi, because if I'm mostly white with just a little bit of blue. And then the Shadow Guild Mage is a card that I don't want to play against if someone is playing red-black. Interesting. I guess I'm deciding between the Teferi and the Crookclaw Transmuter. Like I say, I probably won't have enough islands in my deck to play this card. It's a pretty nasty ambush, though, against an attacking creature. But I'm going to take Crookclaw Transmuter, just more likely that I get to put in my deck. Okay. So a colorless land is decent if I do wind up mono white, but this is just so expensive and a little bit off theme. Flagstones of Trocaire doesn't really do anything noticeably different than a Plains. These blue cards are not great for what I'm trying to do. And then there's Julrael, Empress of Beasts, which is pretty good, I guess. I mean, kind of like a big finish type card. I could see taking that. I seem to be getting cut on white in this pack, maybe. Which, yeah, I don't know. I don't know what to make of that. Um, Yeah, maybe Jewel Royale is really good. Well, go ahead and pick her up at any rate. Okay, there's the Icacian Crier. Make some tokens. Turn on my Gaze of Justice, my Fortify. Alternatively, it would probably be Viscerid Deepwalker, which is just not that great. I'm going to take Icacian Crier. Here's what I was really looking for. Ivory Giant is a great card. The one mana suspend guys are all pretty good in this format, but Ivory Giant's particularly nice in a mono white deck. It's kind of like a big finish type card. And interestingly, I lost to someone earlier today that was momentary blinking their Ivory Giant to just kind of lock all of my creatures out. So if I do wind up white-blue, which is probably one of the more likely scenarios, that could be a cool thing to do. Sonic Blast is also tempting. This card's very, very good, but I like Ivory Giant better. This is just a defensive wall, not very good, not what I'm looking for. Ashcoat Bear is okay. What does this do? One damage to each creature without flying. Yeah, I guess I'll take this bear. In case I do get a really good green card and play the Jewel Royale and the bear. Fledgling Mawkor Wheeling, that's very surprising and probably is going to be enough to make me play blue. Drifter Illidan, not exactly what I'm looking for. It is an aggressive card, but kind of a weird one. I guess that's probably what I'll take since nothing else is appealing for me. This card, Haunting Him, is good, but it's neither good for my deck nor is it very good against me since I'm trying to be a little faster, lower to the ground. I'll take Drifter Illidan, you know, just in case. Ophidian Eye is pretty decent with all the shadow creatures. Sure, Screeching Sliver, don't think I'll play it. Alright, so the cards that I'm probably not going to put in my main deck. I'll keep all of the white creatures in there for now. I just can't really imagine any of these cards being good. Maybe Flowstone Channeler is a card that I don't want to play against. Alright, give my Sliver of Shadow. I don't know if I'm going to have enough blue mana in my deck for Temporal Eddy. This card's actually not that bad. I would hope to only sideboard it, but there are a lot of annoying cards with activated abilities in this format, so I could see boarding then. Alright, so we have Hunting Moa, which is a good green card, but hoping not to be green at this point. Psionic Sliver, one of the better slivers. There's one card in particular that goes super well with this, which is a white uncommon that gives all your slivers +0/+2. If I could assemble that combo, it would be pretty great, but let's see what else is in the pack. Griffin Guide is excellent. Really good way to just earn a quick win in a white weenie deck. Another Quilled Sliver, which would be fine. Or, I guess, Looter Ilkor. I'm going to take Griffin Guide here. I like this card a lot. But it's another non-creature, so I'm going to have to continue putting a really, really high premium on creatures, and specifically white creatures, if I want to make my deck function the way it's supposed to. Evangelize. Gain control of target creature, creature of an opponent's choice that he or she controls. Pretty good, I guess, in some matchups. I have another Rebel Searcher here, which is probably what I'm going to take. This card does absolutely nothing, gives Enchanted Player an extra upkeep. Don't know why I'd want that. A Momentary Blink in the pack, so if I could wheel either Evangelize or Momentary Blink, I'll be pretty happy. But definitely going to take the Rebel Searcher. That gives me Children of Corliss, 1, 2 Amru Scouts, 2, 3, Doomsayer, 4, and the Zealots, 5, 6. So doing pretty well in terms of Rebels. Wow, Worm Calling. That card's pretty sweet. I don't know if it's enough to make me switch out of blue when I have a really good card and a few other solid cards. I don't think my deck's going to have a ton of mana, so I don't imagine I'll be the type of deck that's going to be buying this back, you know, making 3-3 worms and buying it back, but it'll probably just be a medium quality efficient creature in my deck. So I'll just go with a white creature. It's another Deavenant Healer. Again, not exciting, but fine. Sure. Maybe I'll want one Fortify in this deck. I don't know. I have a lot of kind of weak creatures. Now, here's a card that's even better than Worm Calling, which is Call of the Herd. Just super efficient beatdown card. Card advantage. Maybe that's good enough to make me switch out of blue and into green. The problem is that there are two cards that are pretty good for me also. Banalish Cavalry and Outrider Encore, which the Cavalry is a better card, but the Outrider is a Rebel. And I have two Rebel Searchers. And there's the Watcher Sliver. But since I didn't take Psionic Sliver, I'm not really strongly considering that. How badly am I going to want to search for Outrider Encore with my Rebel Searchers? Probably pretty badly. I think I'll take it. It's a shame to pass up Call of the Herd. It's so good. And another Ivory Giant. Exactly what I'm looking for. Especially if I'm fortunate enough that the Momentary Blink might wheel. Okay, what's this do? Gust Cloak Cavalier. Just a way over... Okay, when it attacks, I may tap target creature. That's kind of appealing. I think I'd rather just take Cloud Chaser Kestrel, a really good, efficient flying creature. Careful Consideration also is super good, but again, erring on the side of white creatures because I need them really badly. Wow, another Griffin Guide. In addition to Castle Raptors, which is quite good, and Pentarch Ward, which is quite good. But I'll go with the Griffin Guide. Griffin Guide got played in Constructed, in Time Spiral Block Constructed. It was like a card for white weenie or white green beatdown. Maybe I just won't play blue. Nah, I mean, I don't have that much incentive to stay mono white, and the cards that I do have are really strong. Sure, I'll take another Doomsayers. It's a Rebel. I like Rebels. So I've got myself a pretty nice white weenie deck here. Here, I'll start putting the maybes over here. I could see playing one Fortify. Could see cutting this 1/1. Or the healers. Another Quilled Sliver. Yeah, pretty good. It's probably better than Deavenant Healer. Does pretty much the same thing, but one mana cheaper. I guess it can, if my opponent has slivers, that can be annoying. There's a Momentary Blink. Watcher sliver. Okay. Now I actually got myself a little sliver package. Pentarch ward, nice. So one thing that's sort of annoying is that when Cloud Chaser Kestrel, of which I have two, when it enters the battlefield, I must destroy target enchantment, mandatory. And I have quite a lot of enchantments, actually, in my deck, so gonna have to either cast these first, or not cast them at all, or hope that my opponent has an enchantment. Alright, this is gonna go in the maybe pile. Fortify in the maybe pile. I'm still just gonna play all my enchantments anyway. It doesn't make sense to cut some of them and leave some of them. So, Pentarch Ward, it gives a creature protection from a color, and I draw a card when it comes into play. Kind of nice. I think I like that card. Yeah, the Transmuter is kind of cool too. Good combo with Watcher Sliver. I'm going to play 17 lands in this deck, probably like, what, 11-6 or... I could see not playing Ophidian Eye if I'm not going to have that much blue mana. And it's, at first I was thinking it's a good combo with the Zealot Ilvec because of Shadow, but if I choose to use the ability of Zealot Ilvec, then I won't get to draw a card with Ophidian Eye. So it's not the greatest combo ever created. That card's fine. I think this is just really good with Ivory Giant. You can just save your guys, too. Save your guys from removal or in combat. So I don't think I'm going to cut any of these spells, but I also don't think I'm going to add any spells from my sideboard. I could see cutting some of these slivers. I want to keep all of my rebels with the exception of this Children of Corliss, which is a little weak. Yeah, the Doomsayers are definitely not exciting. Ooh, this guy's a rebel. I did not even know that. It's great. And I'm actually having a hard time evaluating this Icacian Crier card. I think it's pretty good, but I'm not too sure. Crookclaw Transmuter with, let's say, I'm going to have five islands in my deck. Probably still good enough. Even despite the fact that it can't tap for the Gaze of Justice. Would have been nice to get more of these. It's one of the payoffs for being nearly mono-white is getting Gaze of Justice because no one else really wants it. But maybe either there's another white weenie drafter or there's just weren't more than one open in the draft. All right, let's just throw in the Icacian Crier and call it a day. So, healthy number of creatures, Temporal Eddy in my sideboard, but I would have to play more islands if I wanted to play that. Got some Quilled Slivers and Deavenant Healers if I'm playing like a White Weenie Mirror against lots of one toughness dudes. But for now, I'm going to go 12 planes, 5 islands. I'm going to take a screenshot of my deck in case I need to look back. And I'm going to submit, and I will see you for round one.